Welcome back to Fostering Faith. We're in season 2, episode 5, and this week we wanted to talk about competence. How has your week been, Gia?
Good.
What's been so good about it?
I don't know, just hanging out with my friends.
How's your weekend?
Good.
Do you have anything else coming up that you're excited for?
The basketball season, that's really it.
What did you do on Sunday?
I put practice volleyball.
So you have a potential to play travel volleyball too this year. Mm-hmm. And so tryouts are coming. Whenever you go into a tryout, what is one of the key things to have?
Confidence.
Why?
Because you have to stand out to them.
Hmm. How would you get confidence in volleyball?
But like thinking, not like, don't think of other people, just think of yourself and how you're good at stuff.
Well, and the fact that you are downstairs hitting balls constantly, and so having confidence that you've practiced your skill, I think is important. What other things, what areas in life do people lack confidence?
I say like following Jesus. I feel like you need confidence to do that.
Okay. What other areas, just in, doesn't have to be about faith, but what other areas do people need help with confidence in?
How they look and how they act and how they like play sport.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. I think that having confidence in that you're made for more, that you are more than what you have, having confidence that you're made in the image of God, and having that as your backbone, because you have to have confidence in knowing who made you, right?
Mm-hmm. So can I ask you some questions about confidence?
Yeah.
Okay, my first question is, how have you used confidence in your life? Like, it doesn't have to be in faith, but, like, how have you used it in?
I think that confidence is important in your profession, in friendships, in relationships, because you have to know what confidence does. I mean, if you walk into a room and your head is, like, down low, what is that bringing? But I think that you have to know what confidence is. And so, you know, like you have like worldly confidence, you have godly confidence. And so society often teaches us that confidence comes from like your talents and achievements and external validation. People strive to build confidence by accumulating success and relying on their own abilities. And then you have the godly confidence that, you know, our God has never failed. You know that God has said, you know, 7,000 promises in scripture. And so you have confidence, not in what you can do, but because we are believers, we have confidence in our God.
Mm-hmm.
And so I think that he has written this love letter that we get to call a Bible and that we get to read every day. And so we're reassured, and we know in our personal lives, because we've seen him work miracles for people that we know. And with that confidence going into your day, your sport, I think that having that confidence, and not in our own ability, but God's ability, is really key.
Why do we need confidence? Like, just random people, why do they need confidence?
Because if you don't have confidence, then how are you going to get anything done? Mm-hmm. Confidence is not the absence of fear. Confidence, sometimes we mistakenly believe that confidence means never being afraid. But confidence isn't about being or never feeling fear. It's about trusting God enough to move forward whenever fear is present. And so you can be, you know, scared and still be confident, as long, you know. So I think that if you walk into a room and you're like, oh, you just feel very kind of, you're not confident in yourself, you're gonna lack that enthusiasm. You're going to lack that zeal. Like you walk into a room and you own it because you're competent in what you're doing.
Mm-hmm.
So I think that having confidence is important, but also too, not being overly confident.
Yeah.
I think that we have to know that we have limitations, but who doesn't have limitations?
God. And I also feel like if you have too much confidence, I feel like it's like gloating, I feel like. Is that the right word? Like,
yeah, I mean, like being cocky.
Yeah. I feel like that's a big one.
And I think that you made a good point too. What is a great scripture about people needing confidence because of how they look? What is a great scripture?
I have this one, Psalms 139:13-18. You made all of the delicate and inner parts of my body and knit me together in my mother's womb. Thank you for making me so wonderful and complex. Your workmanship is marvelous. How well I know it. You watched me as I was being formed in the utter
seclusion,
as I was woven together in the dark of the womb. You saw me before I was born. Every day of my life was recorded in your book. Every moment was led out before a single day was passed. How precious are your thoughts about me, oh God, they cannot be numbered. I can't ever count them. They outnumber the grains of sand. And when I wake up, you are still with me.
And so that's one of the most famous Psalms. It was written by David. And so David had so many, you know, problems and issues. And was he a sinner?
Yeah, everyone's a sinner.
Yeah. And so David got to write a large part of scripture. And in that book of Psalms, and that's what I'm studying right now, it's such a good book. If you guys need something to read, I would so encourage you to go and pick up Psalms. It's a book of songs, and it's a book of just being mad at God and just asking and worshiping and praising God. And so it's really just kind of encompassing all in one. And it's such a good book. But, you know, David, he had fought Goliath. And so do you think that he came in there all like, oh man, like, I don't even know what I'm doing. Or do you think that he walked into that battle with Goliath, you know, knowing that he was going to be able to do it?
Yeah, I feel like he thought he would be able to do it because he took off all of his armor because, like, it was so heavy. And then he just...
Whose armor was he trying to wear?
Oh, I don't know idea.
Saul's. And so that is such a beautiful message in itself, is that if you're trying to wear someone else's clothes and they're so big, because Saul was a big man, and so he tried to put that armor on David that was not meant for David. And so whenever you try to put on clothes that you're not meant to wear, you can't act like God made you.
Mm-hmm.
And I think that we can unpack that. That's so good right there. I think that whenever you are trying to be somebody that you're not as effective as what you could be. So I think that it's important to remember that you are beautifully and wonderfully made, that God made you. Do you remember whenever we went to Mexico and we were sitting on the beach kind of that morning before we left, and we just looked, I said, just look at all the sand.
Oh yeah, you told me that.
And so just planning. And so moms and dads, whenever you're listening to this, you know, just having those moments when you're just outside in nature and just kind of reiterizing what scripture says. And so just kind of making those practical, like, little suggestions whenever you're on a beach. It doesn't have to be in Mexico. You know, it could be at your local beach, you know, here in, you know, Southern Illinois. You could just go to that lake and just look of how many grains of sand, and that's how many times God has thought about you.
Mm-hmm.
Just to put it into a visual picture.
So my third question is, how can you use confidence with God? Like, how to like spread and everything. How can you use confidence with that?
I think that you have to be rooted in your confidence in God. And so with having confidence in God, I think that you've seen his past promises, you've seen what he's done, and daily dependence on him and knowing him in your walk in faith, that your daily dependence and your confidence in Christ grows daily as we place our trust in him. It's not going to be a one-time event, but it's a continuous whole process of like just surrendering our lives and our choices to him and just, you know, having those daily habits like we've talked about in our previous messages about praying, being in the word, relying on it and knowing what his promises says. You know, you have Proverbs 3:5 and 6, it says, trust in the Lord with all your heart and do not lean into your own understanding, and always submit to him and he will make your path straight. When we put our trust in the Lord with all of our heart, we don't rely on our own understanding or strength. It creates a foundation of confidence at last, because he's never lost a battle. And we know that this because we have scripture. And is there any lies in scripture?
No.
And so if we believe, if we're cover to cover girls, and women and men, we know that the truth is in scripture. So we know that he's never lost a battle. Mm-hmm. We know that he's not going to start with us. And so whenever we're spreading the gospel, whenever we're, you know, telling people about our faith, and we're not trying to win people over, but we're allowing them to know that there is a better option. The only way to heaven is through Jesus, is through Christ. And whenever we're telling them about that, we can be confident knowing that this is what scripture says. And that's what we're going off of. Knowing who we are in Christ is where our foundation and confidence and understanding our identity in Christ. And we're not defined by failures or insecurities or what others say about us. We're defined by what God says about us. What does God say about us in Ephesians?
Ephesians 2:10 I have right now. For we are God's masterpiece. He was created as us anew in Christ Jesus, so we can do the good things he planned for us long ago.
And so whenever we lack our confidence, we have that scripture to go back on. And we're a masterpiece. And so for the listeners, what can you tell them if they're having lack of confidence in how they look?
It really doesn't matter how you look, really, because it's only like the inside, I feel like, that counts, because the inside can be, and I think will most likely be, the most beautiful thing about people.
And we were made in God's images, and so you're beautiful. Mm-hmm. You're beautifully and wonderfully made. You are a masterpiece. You are a creation. And so I think it's really important whenever we're having insecurities about if we have a zit on our face or we don't have the right makeup, you have to realize that you are beautiful, that you are amazing, that you were literally made for a reason, for a plan. And that if you are feeling that low and just kind of mopey one day, just knowing that the God of the heavens that made that beautiful flower, that made that amazing bird, made you too.
Yeah. Okay. My fourth question is, where could we use confidence at? Like in our day-to-day lives?
Knowing who we are in Christ. Knowing that we have a heavenly father that has never lost a battle, that we have confidence in knowing that God has a great plan for us.
Mm-hmm.
We can be confident in knowing that God is for us and not against us. We can be confident knowing that he will never leave us.
Mm-hmm.
We can be confident in knowing that we are going to go to heaven. That there is a heaven, there is a hell. We are confident that we know the devil is a liar. we can be confident in knowing that we are beautifully and wonderfully made. We can be confident in knowing that we are doing the right thing. Confidence in the world is fleeting, but confidence in God is unshakable. Our confidence comes from trusting in God's strength and not our own. We're confident in knowing that we are weak and He is strong. We are confident that we can overcome fear and find courage when we keep our eyes on Jesus. And so I think that's also, too, a great point to bring up whenever Peter walks on water in Matthew 14. And so, again, if you've not read that scripture, I would encourage you to go back and read Matthew 14, 22 through 33, and we won't read it here, but when Peter saw Jesus walking on the water, he had confidence to step out on the boat, and his confidence came from the command that whenever Jesus had come, and whenever Peter took his eyes off of Jesus and focused on the wind and the waves, and he began to sink, but God was so close, Jesus was so close, he reached out his hand and saved him, and he said, "Why did you doubt?" And our confidence falters when we take our eyes off of Jesus and we focus it on our fears and our circumstances. And so we can be confident that we will fail if we don't focus on Jesus. You know, and I think that in the midst, in Psalm 23 is another good one. I've set the table in the midst of your enemies. And so if we focus in on Jesus, I think that we can't lose, and focusing on Him instead of our fears and worries and doubts, we can be confident, knowing that we can do extraordinary things with Him. What does 2 Timothy say about?
I have 2 Timothy 1:7. For God has not given us a spirit of fear, but a power of love and a sound of mind.
And that's another thing that we can be confident in, is that we have the Holy Spirit to guide us, to nurture us, to love us, to grow, to mature us, and to reject fear and embrace the power of courage. And we did a podcast on courage versus what confidence is. And I think that it's important to realize what is inside of you, what God has put inside of you. And I think that will help you get through the day. What are some issues that you think teens face as far as confidence?
I feel like a lot of it is having to do with, like, our bodies and stuff. And, like, if we're good enough or anything like that.
Whenever we talk about knowing that you are good enough, knowing that you have a Heavenly Father that is supporting you, does that make you more confident?
Yes, it does. Because I feel like then I can always, like, if I get in a fight with my friends or with you or, like, with anyone, I can just go to Him because He's always by my side.
What else are you confident in?
I feel like I'm confident in basketball, but not too confident. I feel like you just have to be, like, right in the middle-ish.
Well, I think that you're confident that you have practiced, that you have skill, that you have talent. But always, you know, keeping an open heart that there's always room to grow. There's always ways to get better and improve.
Mm-hmm.
What are some practical tips that people could do to help build their confidence in what they're lacking?
Just think that you are made in God's image. That's literally all you can think about, that you are perfectly made in God's image, so there's nothing wrong with you.
No, there's not. I mean, and I think that we all know that we're all sinners. We're all not perfect. And so, but if you're ever feeling lack or, you know, that you're not, why am I here? It's because you're here for a purpose. You're here for a reason. God has intended you to even just hear this podcast to encourage you, to build you up.
Mm-hmm.
And that's what we're here to do. In Fostering Faith podcast, we are here to motivate you and just encourage you, to love on you. We're going to take this time too to ask you guys to rate and review, hit that subscribe button and share this around the world. I think that with the confidence that we have in spreading the gospel, because we are confident that our God is real, that we are followers of Christ, that we believe confidently that there is a heaven, we believe confidently that there is a hell, that we are confident that this book is the book of truth, it is the book of life, and that we are loved and that we are wonderfully and beautifully made and that we're all here for a reason. Would you want to close us out in scripture or in prayer?
Dear God, thank you for us today. Thank you for everything you've given us. I pray for the people listening to this and the people in the world that they'll just have confidence and just walk the world bringing confidence and spreading your word. And I pray that no one will get hurt this week. And I pray for everyone that is sick and hurt and that they will feel better. In Jesus' name I pray, amen.
Amen. And so stay tuned for us next week. And don't forget to leave us a review on Apple Podcasts. And we're going to use this time to say thank you to some people that have left some reviews on our... We wanted to thank you for the conversation that we had and the Hanson Lawn Care, who wrote us a review. It says, Fostering Faith is an incredible podcast that truly inspires and uplifts. Each episode delves into a meaningful discussion about faith, personal growth, and community. The hosts are engaging and authentic, making you feel like you're part of a heartfelt conversation. The stories shared with both reliable and encouraging, reminding us of the power of faith that we live. I always come away feeling motivated and spiritually enriched. Highly recommend that everyone looking into deepening their faith journey. So thank you so much for leaving that kind review, and we hope that this message encouraged you. Have a great week.
Bye.